we do want to extend that further and make the house and everything.
No, not a house.
Like, not a house, but give them more, like,
because shelter, I was thinking, okay, if we were to go with the family idea, we'd pick a family that needs more medical attention, like they're more injured. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, they have a caravan, but what can we do to help them? So we have to ask them, what do you need?
Like, and also people with a lot of kids too.
Where are you at in the process?
So we know we have two different ideas. We have the family we might support, but we kind of changed our minds because we were informed that they all have caravans. And then we also have the hospital in Syria, which we'd send money through Health for Refugees.
So we were thinking about doing the hospital instead of the family because it has a greater impact on people and it will help their medical, it will give them medical attention and it will be more helpful in the long run. Right, guys?
Yes.
I'm Dana.
I'm Lynn.
I'm Lena.
And we're Allies on the Line. And this is our event.
We're going to be raising money for a startup budget for the club Lives on the Line that's going to be helping Syrian refugees.
And Health for Refugees is going to be sending the money to a hospital in Aleppo.
And this event's purpose is to raise awareness through creative means, whether it may be art or media or just even a poem.
Yeah, or anything you guys want to do, acting, singing, skits, just make sure it's creative and it's through the arts.
We're going to be inviting the person that's going to be continuing Lives on the Line next year. I'd like to introduce you all to Taraf Jaro.
I really enjoyed this event, how it helped promote the building of hospitals for refugees in Aleppo, and I will be continuing this initiative next year, and hopefully the budget that we've gained from this year will help initiate the continuation of the projects for next year.
So now we're gonna show you guys a video that Dana did back in December, where she put up these murals and people were free to draw or write anything that they associated with war or refugees.
Yeah, I'd rather be a lover than a fighter. Cause all my life I've been fighting. Never felt a feeling of comfort. All this time I've been hiding. And I never had someone to come home. Oh, nah, I'm so used to shit. Love only left me alone. But I'm at one with the silence. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been quiet for too long. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been silent for too long. For favors, my whole life I felt like a burden. I think too much and I hate it. I'm so used to being in the wrong.
We are the world, we are the children, we are the ones who make a better day. So let's start giving. There's a choice we're making.
I'm a proud, passionate Palestinian. That's how I identify myself the most. I hear the sounds of birds chirping. They hear the sounds of bombs exploding. I see sunshine. They see bloodlines. I hear people singing. They hear children screaming. I see family loving. They see families dying. My brothers and sisters. You might think I don't know them, but trust me, we're the same person. So why do we live so differently? They die in an open-air prison or terrorist paradise every second that I breathe.
So, my piece, I drew a portrait of a Syrian refugee boy for this thing called the Memory Project. And the Memory Project is where they send pictures of these Syrian refugee children to students in high school and middle school who are artists. And they draw them, and then we send them back to the children who are in camps and in war in different countries and places. And this can help them feel like someone actually cares about them and that they feel important.